makes his move, spins in the paint, turns, puts it up, puts it in. Ja Morant knocks it down.
Morant driving
goodness.
What a play. Gracefully, elegantly takes it in, soaring for the two. Morant takes it in. He's gone mad in this game.
He's got superior athleticism.
They go into Morant. Oh, my goodness. Beautiful play by Ja Morant.
Well, Memphis made the playoffs last year for the first time since drafting Ja Morant. This is the Grizzlies team preview. That's Channing Frye, Chris Miles. And when we say Ja Morant was sensational, spectacular, the numbers speak for themselves. You ready, Channing? In the playoffs.
Yes.
Okay, we're going playoff Ja Morant.
Ooh, I'm excited.
30 points per game.
Ooh.
8 assists per game. 51% from the field. 40% from three-point range. In a regular season, that's 19-7. So, when looking at Ja Morant, what he was able to do in the postseason, do you anticipate a leap in production this year?
Absolutely. This is one of my favorite teams to watch. The biggest thing, and I say this all the time when I refer to Ja Morant, is basketball skills aside, right? He is a culture bringer. Every night he brings a certain level of not only anticipation for the amazing moves and the things that he does, but you just assume that he's going to make a play for them to win the game. He makes everyone better on the court. His teammates are inspired by him. He's working on the things that he needs to. He's 22 years old, like, which is wild. Usually you go, well, let's give a guy a couple years to rebuild. The minute he got there, they were fighting for that playoff spot. So for him to get it, obviously they were the eighth, you know, last year and had to play Utah. They had to play Utah, which was a beast in itself. I think this year, if they could stay healthy, this team is definitely a top six in the Western Conference. I think they take that leap.
Now, the three-point shooting, we always focus on Giannis and Simmons. We hear it so much. But young point guards have traditionally gotten that rap like, oh, if you can shoot from outside. For Ja, 40% in the postseason. What does that tell you about his development?
Well, that he's working on it, right? I don't need you to be, if you're an apple, be an apple, right? He is a downhill attacker. But if you're making it, I don't need you to shoot 10. I don't need you to shoot 8. You give me 5 or 6, and let's say you make 3 of those, you're shooting 50% on top of everything else that you're doing. Just make the defense play honest. And if he can get the defense to go over top with his downhill speed, obviously with the scoring that his teammates, they're also growing. They're also learning and developing. I think Kyle Anderson is also one of the unsung heroes on that team. I think his ball handling, putting Ja Morant off the ball a little bit, bringing in some physicality with Steven Adams instead of Valanciunas, some veteran presence. For me, it's going to make them even more dangerous because Ja Morant is absolutely explosive. And sometimes I say he's violent going towards the rim. And he's going to try you, right? He doesn't care whether you're Gobert, whether you're Yao Ming, whether you're Channing Frye or Kevin Love. He's going to try to dunk on your head.
Well, you just made me switch up and think of the most important Ja Morant question. You said he chooses violence whenever he goes to the rim. Is he the most exciting in-game dunker today?
No. I think that's Miles Bridges.
Okay.
Listen, we're not talking about the Charlotte Hornets, but I think that's another. If I had to go east and west, my two young teams that are absolutely dynamic and for people to want to watch good, fun basketball, those are my two teams to watch. But the Grizzlies, they play the right way. They have a great defensive mindset. They take on the challenge every single night. They feel like it, and they act like they deserve to win. So, you know, Memphis Grizzlies fans ain't too happy with me, but, you know, hey, they got a great team, and I'm excited to watch them this year.